All right, so I've moved the pork out of the studio. And we'll see if... I wonder if it will last between now and I'm off the air. I don't think so. I think I've got more pork than I have bread, though. I bought 3 loaves, too. Anyway, we're down to the last one. And most of the Robbie's gone, too. So I will have video and the recipe on our website, nj1015.com. The trick is, if you're going to do it at home, don't use a crock pot. I find it's much harder. It doesn't pull the same way, for this recipe at least. You got to use a Dutch oven, right? So, Eric, you saw that. That was a Creuset Dutch oven.
Yes, I have a bunch of them. I love them. I never use a crock pot ever again.
Ever. You can't control the temperature the same way.
No.
You need to be precise, I think. So I did 6 hours at 225.
Okay.
And then 2 hours at 200.
Okay.
And it's funny. So the Creuset Dutch oven has that handle, that hardened plastic handle. Right. So when I first came up with this recipe, I was the secret to it is taking the handle off the top, because it creates.
I never would have thought to do that.
Well, here's how I thought to do it. I was not smart enough. It happened by accident. I am a bit of a fire phobe. I have a bit of a paranoia. You know, I check the stove before I leave the house. I have all kinds of issues. So I'm looking at this thing, and I'm like, I don't think I should put that in the oven for 10 hours. Now, it's designed to go in the oven.
It is.
But my insanity, I'm like, no, I'm taking it off. And you know, my wife's like, you're crazy. I'm like, no, but I don't like this idea. It could melt. I never know. So I unscrew it. So part of my cooking utensils includes a screwdriver. So I take the handle off, replace the top, do the whole thing. Comes out spectacular. Now, I didn't know until about a year later, I cook it again, and I had the handle on because I overcame my fear, and it wasn't as good. It was harder to pull. So I'm like, that's the trick. How about that?
Yeah.
I learned by accident. Just that little tiny steam vent.
Yep.
And the bones pull
makes
right
total
out.
Sense.
How about that?
Total sense.
Go figure.
Yep.
So you need to vent a little bit, slight vent. And it's easy. So buy a pork shoulder. Now, there are multiple bones in a pork shoulder, whereas a pork butt, you only get the one bone.
Right, right.
So this was a whole shoulder. So there were 3 bones that I pulled out of it.
Yep.
And they came out. I've got pictures. I'm going to post the pictures of the bones just because it's ridiculous. Like they're clean. Like they just pull right out. But it's simple. You take the pork shoulder, you brine it. So the brine had Italian parsley, rough chopped, 4 cloves of garlic in the brine. So 12 cloves of garlic were used in the making of this sandwich.
We are vampire proof.
Oh yeah. Forget it. Are you kidding? It'll last a couple of days too, when you use that much. So, and then red pepper, salt, and sugar. And I brined it in a tub in the fridge. I actually defrosted it, 'cause remember I bought 2 and I froze 1. So it defrosted for about 36 hours in the fridge. Pull it out, pat it dry a little bit, trim off any of the excess fat. Like if there's anything flapping around, you just want to get, you know. And I coat it with olive oil. I cake it almost in the rough chopped parsley. I used a whole bunch, like the entire bunch.
Those are the Italian parsley.
Right. Another 4 cloves of garlic, rough chopped again, just kind of pressed against the skin. Red pepper, salt, and pepper. That's it.
Very simple.
It's so easy.
Yeah.
It's so easy. Now, Dan, you had noticed that there were no fat chunks in it.
I did. And it's very noticeable because every bite is delicious and amazing.
Thank you. I actually go through it I pull it with 2 forks. So I'm separating the pork with 2 forks. And as you come across pieces of fat, you pull it out.
So you're pulling and pulling out.
Pulling
from
the
pork.
The whole thing. Yes. Thanks, Dan. And Eric. You know what? It is Monday morning. Let's just move on.